So let's talk about the Mac Pro problem. Apple updated its trade-in program valuations of existing Macs, and it's pretty depressing even by Apple standards. Now let's say I wanted to trade in my valued $13,000 Mac Pro and upgrade to something with Apple Silicon if I don't want to wait for the Mac Pro version, which we will talk about in a minute. And so I say, you know what, I miss having a laptop, so I'm going to go ahead and order a 16-inch, and we are going to get the M2 Max. 96 gigs of RAM compared to my 160. Storage won't go crazy. I'll just go like 2 terabytes is good enough for internal storage, I think. All right, and that is valued at $4,699 pre-tax. Now again, this machine is valued at 13. Of course, I'm not gonna get 13 from a trade-in program, but I think it should offset the cost a fair amount. $970. Now, what's crazy is that is not just for my specific machine. That is the cap for all Mac Pros. All those studios and people who bought $52,000+ fully spec'd out Mac Pro are getting the same trade-in values. So actually, my favorite source for trading in Apple products has always been Mac Me and Offer. This video, I'm not affiliated with them in any way whatsoever. Generally, for the past decade, whenever I've sold or traded in products, this is where I've sold it to. Now, right off the bat, you can see that their estimate for the base model mid-2019 is $2,125. Already astronomically better. Again, this is based on a $6,000 computer, and you're basically getting a third of the value 2 years later. I don't know if that's great or not, but it sure beats $970. The other difference that I really love Mac Me and Offer is one of the questions that they ask is, does your product have any extraordinary upgrades? So this is where you can actually go in and say, hey, I upgraded the RAM to 160 gigs. I added a secondary GPU, basically all these upgrades that add a ton of value to the computer. But herein lies the next Mac Pro problem. Because it is now the final Intel machine, and because this computer's kind of become laughable, and that's not to say it's not a good computer. I'm going to touch on that in a few minutes. But last year, Max Tech did a great video comparing his $15,000 Mac Pro to the Mac Studio with the Ultra chip. And in almost every scenario, the Studio just blew the Mac Pro out of the water, and it's literally like a third of his cost. And so a month or two ago, before these M2 MacBook Pros and the new trade-in values came out, I actually did this process through Mac Me and Offer. And you know the response I got after I submitted the custom estimate offer? They said, so sorry, we don't want it. Because no one wants to buy an Intel Mac anymore, especially for the crazy inflated prices that the Mac Pro costs, when you can get more performance for a fraction of the price. And so they were just like, great computer, but it's just gonna be too hard to sell for us to even want it at this time. So it seems the only option left is to sell privately. 29 Mac Pro on eBay. We can see literally yesterday someone bought this 16 core for 6,000, this 12 core for 4,800. The computer is still selling. But now let's talk about the much more interesting topic to me. Should you sell it? Because again, I love my Mac Pro. I love the customizability, being able to add those extra GPUs, add the storage, the fact that I have 16 ports on mine and all but one are taken up. And obviously I bought the computer out of a need. I had the 2013 trash can Mac Pro and it was slowing down my video creation. And so this for the past 2 or 3 years has been allowing me to produce videos a lot better than any other computer I've ever had. But I'm really starting to feel the effects of not having Apple Silicon. So many developers now, it just makes sense to have so much optimized power that they are building their apps specifically for Apple Silicon, and you actually won't be able to touch the same feature sets or performance that you can on the Intel Mac. One of the perfect examples of that is today's sponsor, Detail. Detail has quickly become one of my favorite Mac apps because it allows you to record from iOS devices wirelessly or wired. You can connect your cinema cameras if you want and easily get a multi-cam experience unlike any other, but it doesn't just stop there as a basic recorder. You can go in, edit your video. Their brand new AI tools allow you to generate auto titles, keywords, transcribes your entire video, and can even pull out highlights from long form content like podcasts to give you amazing social content you can cut down for YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels, or TikToks. Detail is currently free to download and check out. If you're a creator of any kind, I highly recommend you check out Detail. Their link will be down in the description below. So yeah, while apps like Detail continue to work on my Mac Pro, when you open it up, it basically says like, hey, you know, this is optimized for the latest Apple Silicon, so you may have not the same exact experience. And when I grab my M1 MacBook Pro, you just feel the optimization on apps like that, even though it's a severely underpowered computer. And that's a problem that's just going to continue to get more stretched out over time. So what should Mac Pro owners do? What people forget is the Pro line is supposed to be different than the consumer line. In the consumer line, we've all gotten used to, hey, new iPhones every year, new Macs maybe every 2 or 3, but the Pro Tower line has always generally been something that at least gets like 5 to 7 years before a totally new updated model comes out. It's not like when this computer was released, no one at Apple knew that Apple Silicon wasn't coming. And so the big question that's continues to be left is, will there be some sort of user upgradable option for existing Mac Pro owners to where we can transition our computers to Apple Silicon? But at the end of the day, whether you have a Mac Pro, a Mac Mini, a MacBook Air, or just any other computer, the question you have to ask yourself is there a need that the new computer would fulfill that my current computer isn't doing? For me, as I said, I'm starting to feel the cons of not having Apple Silicon as DaVinci Resolve gets way more optimized for Apple Silicon. I know that the performance would be far better on the newer chips. Apps like Detail would work better and I'd get all of the fancy features, but it's not at the point now where I'm like desperately trying to sell this thing. I've held out long enough where I just need to see what Apple is going to do with the Mac Pro. What do you guys think? Let me know down in the comments below. Until next time, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video. Video.